Alright folks, this is the $60, fairly new, DeathAdder V2X HyperSpeed from Razer. This is an entry into the DeathAdder ecosystem of mice or a few other options, including this really awesome DeathAdder V2 Pro. This is $130 with a 20K sensor, nice rubber gripping on the side, and RGB. But on the DeathAdder V2X HyperSpeed, I have to keep reading the name because it's hard to remember the order of all those words. It's a 14K DPI instead of a 20. You don't have the rubber grips on the side, and there are no RGBs, right? No RGBs at all. There's also no wired option, so you have to make sure that your mouse always has a battery. It does take either a AA or a AAA battery. One of the advantages to that is, you know, whatever you have lying around, boom. But also, it's a weight difference. There's a 10-gram difference between the two batteries. So 102 or 103 grams with the AA inside and about 92, 93 with just the AAA inside. You do not get extra battery life if you put them both in there, which is a bit of a shame. Okay, now, with all of, at least in my experience with Razer's mice that have a top cover, trying to get them back in, you've got to be a little gentle with it. So if you were to take it and put it in bottom first, okay, what happens is you have to then click in the top buttons, both of them, in order to get them correctly inside. And that's because of these, let me try to get in the camera, these guys right here. So instead, try to go top first. There you go. And now it's going to give you more longevity. You're not going to wear out that plastic as quickly, maybe not even at all if you do it that way. Okay, another big change from this mouse and that V2 Pro, and even like Razer's Basilisk, is they moved the traditionally assigned DPI buttons from below the scroll wheel to the top left. My natural state is just left of center with the left click. I honestly thought that I was going to run into these before I realized I had a natural state. So I had to keep putting my hand on my mouse, be like, okay, how come I'm not pressing those? My instinct was I would hit these. I haven't been hitting them at all unless I'm trying to. And of course, you can assign these to anything you want. The default is DPI. I frankly just kind of set it to one DPI and that's it. I'm not much of a crazy gamer. But anyway, I would definitely recommend not being scared of this mouse just because of the position. Like, give it a shot, especially at $60. You get a nice wireless mouse from Razer, Bluetooth or through 2.4 gigahertz, you know, wireless transmission. It's a really nice entry into the space. You could, of course, always go with the Pro if you have the funds and you really want to upgrade to something a little more sensitive and better built because of the rubber on the sides and the RGB. But you could save that money, and I'm seriously pimp this mouse. I've been really enjoying this. This is the ProClick Mini. It came out at the end of 2021. So silent. I mean, listen to this. So anyway, give it a shot. Good mouse. Good job, Razer, and thanks for sending it over for review. Cheers.